Let's take a look at the exciting option to put a motorized fader into your RCP. So the RCP I have shown in a different video previously is version 2 of the RCP product we have had for a few years. Really awesome, super universal, lots of displays with OLED legends that will make it the most perfect universal RCP you have ever had in your hand. The only thing is that this joystick is, as ever, a fixed component. Well, we all love it. It's a classic Iris joystick with a push functionality from the top and a ring for Master Black and so forth. But it has a limitation. The limitation is if you prefer to have a multi-camera RCP, then this will always be a problem for you. Because when you change to a different camera, the joystick will be out of sync with where that camera is. Now, this is solved by the upgrade. You can upgrade or you can add as an option a motorized fader instead of the Iris joystick to your RCP, and then it becomes the perfect multi-camera RCP, which has a really tiny form factor, right? Because with this one, you'll save a bit of space since you can just select which camera you want to operate, and the same RCP does it. So let's take a look at that. It's actually the only thing configured on this one. So if you want to see what all the bells and whistles are on these products, you'll have to go to the video with this one because there you get the full story. In this case, we're only focusing on the Iris joystick. It is powered over PoE, so power over Ethernet, signals as well. Currently, this is connected to a Blackmagic ATEM switcher. So in the other end, I have this switcher sitting, which stores the values for the Iris and relays it out to the cameras. And that's really cool for showing you this functionality, because you can see the values flowing forth and back and how it affects the Iris fader. Okay, let's take a close-up look at the RCP. Just quickly, we have the displays up here for adjusting Master Black and all these other things. But it's down in the bottom that we want to look. So you can see I can adjust the Iris by moving the fader right here. And if you look in the ATEM software control just next to, you saw that this is actually what's happened when I pull this here. It corresponds to moving the fader over here. Now, in the top of the RCP, I chose to use these buttons as a camera selector. So when I press this button, I'm now at camera 2, this is camera 3, camera 4. And now I'm going back so you can see the slider and how the slider moves. So now I go back to camera number 1 and you can see the fader moves and goes to Iris 64. I go now to camera 2, it moves to 50%, 58, 30% and so forth. So now it would be camera 4 and you can see if I move this handle in the ATEM software control, yes, it is Iris 4, camera number 4. There's really not much more to say to this other than it's a cool feature. You can basically assign it to as many cameras as you want. No, that's not true, but you can assign it to at least 8 cameras. There are 8 buttons which will make it useful for 8 cameras if that is your preferred camera selector. Okay, yeah. So I think that's the basic message. I hope you enjoy it and you'll receive this news well. We think it's super innovative. If you want to have multiple cameras available at the same time, but still with motorized faders, you should take a look at the ColorFly panel. So on the ColorFly panel, you have immediate access to 4 sliders, but you have a shift key so you can go to 8 cameras, 12 cameras, 16 cameras by pressing or cycling the shift level off the controller and the faders will adjust. So that's another option. We are basically in the business of options, giving you universal broadcast controllers for all your control needs. Let's get this-